Welcome back to Azure AI Essentials. Today, we're going to take a look at how you, as a developer, can access the same AI capabilities that power Microsoft. Microsoft uses industry-leading AI models across the organization in numerous solutions, and we make those same AI capabilities available to you to use in your own applications. In fact, many of you may be interacting with Azure AI every day without knowing it. Take, for example, Xbox. Xbox uses Personalizer, one of Azure's cognitive services, to personalize the type of content gamers see on their Xbox home screens. By using Personalizer, Xbox is able to deliver catered content to their subscribers, leading to a 40% lift in user engagement. The Personalizer service functions by ingesting information about a given user, in this case, an Xbox gamer, and provides content suggestions to surface back to them. The ingested information includes things like the user's last gaming achievements, online friends, gaming style, or even the day of the week. Normally, the process of selecting what content to surface to users would go through multiple cycles of data labeling, model training, and integrations. Then, the different content options would have to be tested by being surfaced to the user and measuring their responsiveness. Personalizer takes care of all of that in one easy-to-use service because it is powered by reinforcement learning. This means that Personalizer works in real time and is dynamic, with its models constantly learning by observing how users respond to different things. The service is very adaptable to any environment, with little to no need for human fine-tuning. Now, let's dive into how you can implement Personalizer in your applications. To get started, you'll first need to have an Azure subscription and create a Personalizer resource to retrieve your key and endpoint. Then, install the Personalizer client library. You'll now need to create a new programming file. I'm doing this in Python today, but you can also do this in other programming languages. Authenticate the Personalizer client with your endpoint and key, and then add the following methods to your program class to represent the content choices that you want Personalizer to select the best content from. Now we need to create a learning loop. The Personalizer learning loop is a cycle of rank and reward calls based off of their respective APIs. The rank API selects the best item from actions based on real-time information you provide about content and context. The reward API sends a reward between 0 and 1 to Personalizer based off how the action selected addressed business needs. Each rank call to personalize the content is followed by a reward call to tell Personalizer how well the service performed. To get the reward score to send in the reward request, the program retrieves the user's selection, assigns a numeric value to it, and then sends the unique event ID and reward score to the reward API. And just like that, we've implemented our Personalizer service. Similar to our other cognitive services, Personalizer was built and proven to meet global scale and security requirements. It's why customers like ZTEC, the technology hub of the multinational drink and brewing company, AB InBev, can deliver tailored recommendations to mom-and-pop grocery stores in Mexico through the Mi Mercado online marketplace. They have seen a nearly 100% uplift in click-through rates for the personalized products and a 67% increase in converting customer interest into orders. It's also why the NBA has partnered with Microsoft, citing Personalizer as one of the key differentiators for their partnership. Now, let's take a look at another cognitive service that's embedded into Microsoft products, the speech-to-text service within Teams. Let's say I'm here on a Teams call, and I want to transcribe my call for easier note-taking. I can do this easily by the simple click of a button, and the transcription will start. In fact, speech-to-text will automatically format and punctuate my call, as well as use speaker recognition to determine who said what. Of course, there are countless other scenarios in which the speech transcription service can be leveraged. KPMG, a leading professional services organization, used Azure Cognitive Services and custom speech AI to build a new risk analytics solution for financial institutions. Their solution uses AI to streamline call transcription, translation, and fraud analytics, cutting time, cost, and effort by as much as 80%. They were also able to get transcription accuracy of at least 90%. Now, let's see how you can use the same speech-to-text service in your applications. You'll first need to install and import the speech SDK. To call the speech service using the SDK, you'll need to create a speech config class that includes your key and region. To recognize speech using your device's microphone, simply create a speech recognizer without passing an audio config. Instead, pass your speech config. If you instead want to use a specific audio file rather than a microphone, you can do this by passing the file name as a parameter. You can also either configure your speech-to-text application to recognize a single utterance, or you can use continuous recognition if you want to control when to stop recognizing speech. I've gone ahead and implemented continuous recognition with a callback to stop when an event is received. With everything set up, we can start calling our speech recognition method. To help visualize this implementation of speech to text, I'm going to use this front end that's already been created. Let's try it out. Hello, how are you doing today? Look at that. It even punctuated my sentence correctly. Speech to text can even transcribe audio to text in more than 85 languages and variants. Let's try this out in the Egyptian Arabic dialect. Ahlan, amlin ay nahardha? As an Arabic speaker, I can verify that that worked correctly, and wow, it's incredible. The possibilities of what you can build with Azure's cognitive services are endless. We're excited to see how you leverage the power of Azure AI and apply these cognitive services and many more to your own solutions. Thank you for joining us on another episode of Azure AI Essentials. Until next time.